Hey guys, so today I wanted to talk to you about explaining differences to children. And this topic came to me because I think I saw somebody ask what you say to kids about your disability. And this is for anybody who is asked why you're, let's say, in a wheelchair, or for any parent who may have a child that eventually will meet somebody who has a disability and will want to find out. For me, I always let kids explore. I don't want any kid to be afraid to touch my wheelchair, touch my knee, my leg, or whatever. Play in the wheelchair if I happen to not be in it. I let the little boy who I babysit do that all the time. I let my godson do it all the time. I lived with my aunt and uncle for 6 months with my family when we were displaced from the hurricane, and my cousin was over with my godson all the time, and he was young enough at the time where he would play in it. You don't want to make a bigger deal, and this goes for any differences in general. I'm just speaking about disabilities because that's what I know, but this goes for racial differences, you know, or any even little differences, like, why is that person's hair blue? You know, I mean, obviously, nobody's lucky enough to be born with blue hair, but, you know, it's all the same to me. You know, the blue hair is a choice. Being born with a disability or of a certain ethnic background may not be a choice. To me, I do believe that we all choose to come here learning different lessons in life and physically looking exactly how we look. But don't make it a big deal is my main piece of advice. You don't want, because it doesn't mean anything. You know, we're all much more similar than we are different if we actually look past the physical and get to know somebody. And it's not a bad or scary or taboo thing either. You don't want anybody to be afraid of people because of how they look. And you don't want anybody to be afraid or ashamed to ask questions either. But at the same time, when I'm approached, I'd rather regular questions first, but since we're talking about kids, obviously they have no filter, something is going to come out. If you are somebody living with a disability and you're watching this video right now, just don't be offended. Don't be offended at the parent or the child for asking anything. Even forgive adults for being stupid and asking stupid things. Just don't make it a big deal. And don't point out the difference. You know what I mean? Like, if somebody sees, like, let's say a wheelchair, and they go, "Mommy, why is this person sitting in there?" Well, why don't you go introduce yourself and ask, and then keep the child there long enough to ask other questions, bond with the person, and actually see that there's a person, a whole person there. And this, like I said, this goes for adults too, because adults can be pretty stupid. I'll never forget, we were in Atlantic City, and she had to have been in her 30s, 40s. This woman was dragging her mother, who was staring at me, And my mom came out with some smart ass remark, but I was just like, you know, and I don't care. I don't care. If somebody's not gonna actually come up to me and get to know me, what do I care how they look at me? And that's how you want to raise any child living with a disability. To not let what other people think bother them, and to embrace who they are, not be embarrassed about it. Because like I said in one of my other recent videos, there's people who are adults who don't even want people to know, like, especially because you can hide it if you're online, who don't want people to know that they have a disability. That's not being who you authentically are. But that's a whole different topic that I've already covered. But you don't want to create a stigma where there shouldn't be one. There shouldn't be any stigmas attached to anything, especially the drug epidemic and all of that. You know, we would never solve that problem if the stigma continues. But you don't want an uncomfortableness to be there if there doesn't have to be. And, by the same token, you don't want anybody to feel inferior or superior either. If we're all equal, stop dividing us into different categories, into different social classes based on money, ability or disability, color of skin. And this goes for all, because both, all sides do it. You know, the ones who feel inferior do it just as much as the ones who feel superior. So it's just enough with the back and forth. Treat everybody equally and teach your kids to do that. To have bonds and fun in life instead of being afraid. I'm not even kidding. I will let any kid play in my wheelchair. Because it breaks the ice. That maybe, if the kid is old enough, their parent put there. Oh, don't go over. You're gonna hurt her. Or, don't go over, you're gonna hurt yourself on the wheelchair. I would never let a kid hurt themselves on my wheelchair. Some could be rambunctious, but I know when to draw the line. But yeah, it's just a topic that came up, and I thought I had enough of an opinion and insight to offer some value to you on it. Thank you guys so much for your support on my last video too. That's, if you haven't seen it, go back to my channel, subscribe while you're there, and watch the other video, and please definitely share that one out. I want to make a difference, starting in the United States, hopefully starting maybe locally here in New York, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, tri-state area, with making this country more accessible for wheelchairs and for parents who have to have a stroller for their children. You know, because a lot of the things that affect us affect them. So thank you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.